I was flipping the pages of the program, and because I think that Alex once again put together a very good roster of people, and I was looking at the page about Dr. Sergey Kalitenko, and he was mentioning a number of cancer cases, and some data in his page. And he is saying that according to the American Cancer Society, there will be an estimated 1,600,085 new cancer cases diagnosed and 595,690 cancer deaths this year alone, 2016, in the US. I did not have this latest 2016 data with me today, but this is very much in line with the data that I have collected myself from the American Cancer Society, saying that one out of two men now are at risk of being diagnosed with cancer, and one out of three women. Now, the American Cancer Society has said that those number of cancer is going to double by 2030. So make the math. If one out of two men today, and this is going to double, it means every man. And one woman out of six will escape. What happened to the so-called war of cancer? What happened to the billions of federal money that has been spent on the issue since 1971 when Nixon signed the War on Cancer Act? We are still burning, cutting, poisoning. It looks like nothing has changed. I don't know if anybody will ever be accountable. We are going to vote in 2 weeks. And this issue is not addressed. Only we are speaking of premiums going up. But our premiums, do they really matter when we are going to be all sick? Why this is what we have done is not working? Where did this money go? We are going to vote. We are entitled to ask those questions. Maybe it went to the wrong place. What do you think? Every man for 2030. Maybe it's not complete desperation. Maybe there are other ways to go. Other places to look at. My father, Dr. Mirko Beljanski, a PhD in molecular biology at the Pasteur Institute in Paris, was laughed at, mocked in the 80s, when he came with the idea that cancer was not just the result of a genetic mutation, but could be the result of environmental toxins daily, cumulatively, progressively poisoning us and making us sick. Here's my father. He died in 1996. He was killed by the French army after they ransacked his laboratory. His idea, the big thing, was to think that if nature had come up with carcinogens, nature had also come up with anti-carcinogens. Looks simple, right? But think about all the money behind pharmaceutical companies. Think about our laws. They're all about patent. In order to be patentable, a molecule has to be new. New is not natural. Nature is very, very old. So if you bring the idea that nature can do better than synthetic, this is actually highly disruptive. And they can kill for that. Actually, they did. So he came up with the idea that nature could bring some anti-carcinogens, potent. And because he was at the Pasteur Institute, a PhD, he really studied, as if it was drugs, a number of natural compounds. He chose two, the pereira and the Rauwolfia vomitoria, and he tested them at the Pasteur Institute, this is the Pasteur Institute in Paris, on different kinds of cancer cells. His idea was that environmental toxins affect our DNA. DNA is the same one. We have one DNA from head to toe. So it's going to work from head to toe, man, woman. It's not gender or organ specific. So here you have, for example, on human liver, here you have thyroid cancer, and here you have breast cancer cell lines. And you can see that both the pereira in blue or the Rauwolfia in green are nicely preventing the development here of cancer cells. They are also here bringing a nice inhibition of cancer cells, and here also. It is not specific of the type of cancer cells. It looks like it's actually working on all of them. We are here on cells. After my father was killed by the French army and I came to the United States, I decided to have this issue seriously researched with a number of American reputable institutions. I was very fortunate to be able to meet with Dr. Aaron Katz at the time where he was head of holistic urology at Columbia University. Head of holistic urology, that means he was interested in prostate cancer. So we decided to work on prostate. And we worked with both the pereira and the Rauwolfia vomitoria. And here are the American publications coming from the work of Columbia University. We are looking here at LNCAP, which is a very common prostate cancer line. And you can see that both the pereira and the Rauwolfia are potent at suppressing cancer cell division. Here, Pau is doing a little bit than Rauwolfia, but both are actually pretty active. We then decided to look at very advanced prostate cancer cases, which are no longer responding to hormonal treatment. And here, we have this new study showing that pereira extract suppresses castration-resistant prostate cancer cell growth. And it works when even the treatment, official treatment, is no longer working. And we know how it works. It acts on signaling a complex called NF-kappa-B, which is a center of inflammation. So we know how it works. We understand that. Very important. Then Dr. Katz had the idea to mix pereira and Rauwolfia vomitoria together, since we have seen that they were both working independently, and to try on a mini clinical trial on men. And we saw that their PSA, so it was men with elevated PSA but no cancer, we saw that both of all the men had a nice decrease of their PSA during the 12-month period of the mini clinical trial. The problem we had with this mini clinical trial is that the men were doing well at the end of the period. They did not want to have a second biopsy. So we had a problem to publish the study. But then we decided to work with Kansas University Medical Center because Dr. Katz was speaking at a conference and I was seated next to Dr. Driscoll with at Kansas University Medical Center. She said, that sounds great. Would you have something for women? And I said, yes, the same thing. It's not gender or organ specific. So we worked on ovarian cancer at Kansas University Medical Center. And again, beautiful results. And it works in synergy with the chemotherapy, carboplatin. Actually, we have 79% of decrease of the volume of the acid, and the pereira potest a potent anti-tumor activity. Then we went with Rauwolfia vomitoria, and again, beautiful result, 87% to 90% of the tumor shrinks, 89% to 97% of the acids. If it was a synthetic drug, that would appear on the first page of the Wall Street Journal. It's natural. We're not going to make money on that. Who cares? Right? Maybe people do care. Here, you have pancreatic cancer, because when she saw those results on ovarian cancer, she said, and what do you think about pancreatic cancer? Because this is really a tough one. So it's worth trying. We have had actually some cases where we saw nice reversal. So here we have, you see here, control group, here gencitabine, here 20 milligrams, just 20 milligrams of pereira, doing much better than gemcitabine. And when you have the combination of gemcitabine and pereira, even better. And then the Rauwolfia also, it's the same thing. Rauwolfia is doing better than gemcitabine. And here, gemcitabine, you can see, is not adding much benefit to the Rauwolfia. So those results, again, were published. By the way, everything is on the booth of the Beljanski Foundation, which is right on the front when you enter by the main page. So you see low toxicity, no side toxic effect associated with those botanicals. All the major organs here had no problem, no tissue damage was detected in any of the group's studies, and actually a strong inhibition of the pancreatic cancer cells and the diminution of the tumors, reaching 70% of inhibition. And that allowed to reduce the quantity of gemcitabine, toxic chemotherapy. And here you have the Rauwolfia, and again, you have a very nice inhibition of the cell growth of the tumor when the cancer and the nice suppression of the growth in mice in vivo. The metastasis were inhibited, very important. Metastasis means that the cancer is traveling and it starts all over again somewhere else. If you have no metastasis, you treat the cancer, it is the end of the nightmare. Okay? So the data suggests that Rauwolfia possesses anti-pancreatic cancer activity and could improve the effect here of the chemotherapy. These are extracts from those publications, which are available, again, on the table in the front. That's not good enough. We wanted to look at cancer stem cells. Cancer stem cells are those which are resistant to chemotherapy, those who can possibly travel and create another cancer somewhere else. Here what they are. Are you familiar with the notion of cancer stem cells? Yes, raise your hands, those you know. Okay, I'm going to explain. So you have here a malignant tumor. You have plenty of different kinds of cells. In gray, let's say normal cancer cells, and in red, you have those which are stem cells, which have this capacity to migrate. You give chemotherapy. Chemotherapy will destroy those in gray, let's say the so-called normal cancer cells, leaves those very resilient stem cells are going to survive the chemotherapy. And they are going to evolve into a new tumor of a mix of regular cancer stem cells and new stem cells. So it's really important to address this, because otherwise you are back to relapse. Those people say that, you know, after 5 years, 10 years, generally the data cuts at 5 years because the relapse happens at six, right? But that's why we have, it's important to look at cancer stem cells. And that's something that was done only in America. My father had no time to look at that. So here you have pancreatic cancer cells, 0 milligram here of Pao Pereira. We are just stem cells, 200 milligrams, all gone, nothing left. Rauwolfia, all gone. So we have to do it again. We have to understand what happens between 0 and 200. So we did it again. And that's about all science is about verification, right? So here you have 0 milligram, 50 milligram, 100 milligrams. The miracle, if I may call it like that, happens between 50 milligram and 100 milligrams for Pao Pereira, and between 100 milligram and 200 milligrams for Rauwolfia. But it works. So we're very excited. We were doing that with pancreas cancer, wanted to see if it was working on other kind of cancer stem cells. So here is ovarian cancer stem cell, and you can see, again, the miracle happening with those two botanicals. So here what we are doing at the Beljanski Foundation, we are studying botanicals. We do not make, we'll never make a lot of money. We are studying them in a way which is as rigorous as if it was drugs. And we are asking for your support in order to do that. That's why we are a non-for-profit foundation. We are going to have a full day of symposium on December 3rd in Manhattan, followed by a fundraising for the foundation. Please, if you have been interested in this kind of research, help us to support. And we have, because our, so far our main support is coming from Natural Source International, who has generously provided the extracts which have been used for the research.